Television plus the internet. Sounds like a no-brainer, right? For Steve Perlman, it was just that. Hello, this is Connor White reporting for Demtech.org. Perlman's basic idea was to bring the internet to those who thought they did not need a computer or were uninterested in learning how to use one. Web TV Networks, which consisted of roughly 70 people, worked on perfecting this product, and on September 18, 1996, Web TV was made available to the American public. By the fall of 1997, Web TV had over 150,000 subscribers. In April 1997, Perlman conditionally agreed to sell Web TV to Microsoft. The eventual price tag was $425 million. In 2001, Web TV Networks was dissolved and MSN TV was born. Not long after this rebranding, MSN TV reached 1 million subscribers. From here, however, it was downhill. I spoke to Dr. James Castingway of Sacred Heart University to find out more about why Web TV failed.
Well, I actually remember when Web TV came out, and I thought it was a good idea. I think what they, you know, you can imagine from a marketing perspective what they were going for, that, you know, they're combining web with television, and I think back then in the 90s, some people were still reluctant to go online. So Web TV is really trying to convince people really to use the internet, and the web is a very user-friendly interface for that.
So where did it all go wrong? Why didn't Web TV take off like it was supposed to?
People were still a little afraid of computers back then. I mean, the computer used to be this object, this cultural artifact that people associated with like smart, difficult things, right? Like some of us think about math, for instance, right? Those are difficult subjects if that's not your area.
As internet speeds continued to creep up during the last few years of the 20th century, Web TV was stuck in dial-up, which did not suffice for many.
So people who said, hey, I want to try out the web through Web TV, they actually got it, and they're using a dial-up modem through their telephone line, and it's a really slow connection, and it didn't really deliver on the experience. On those commercials, though, they did the classic thing, which was they actually showed real video.
Web TV Plus gives you fast, easy access to the internet. Explore, email, chat, shop, even check stats.
And that was kind of misleading. They puffed it a little bit too much in the infomercials, and they set their expectations too high.
Web TV's main problem, however, may be one that it could not avoid: time.
I think coming a little bit too early, the technology not quite being there, having the right idea, and then overpuffing on the marketing is why it died.
Recently, the idea of the web on television has had new life breathed into it. Television is now being delivered to many homes by fiber optics or satellite, two mediums which serve Web TV's original idea much better than the aforementioned dial-up. So while Web TV may be a dead media, and one that was never really alive, there is a good chance that it has passed the torch onto a descendant who could be around for a very long time. For Demtech.org, this is Connor White.